Hello again. Hi, everybody. It's Gracie. Hope you all are doing fine. Love to read for you this evening. However, I am going to be reading from Irma Rambaran's short story, some excerpts. This is a tribute to Irma Rambaran. Irma and I, we worked alongside each other in the Guardian newspaper when we were young ladies. I was pretty young then. After a few years, I was revisiting this journal that I did in 1979. Irma Rambaran was a contributing writer to this journal. She was a young reporter with the Guardian newspaper in Port of Spain at that time, as I said. But when, at the time of revisiting this publication, I spoke to Irma and she told me she was completing her doctorate. May Irma's soul rest in peace. Amen. Let's start some work. The name of Irma's short story is Derek. It starts like this. What was wrong with that boy? I heard my mother shouting to the air as she went into the kitchen, where she was preparing dinner for my father, my sister Vashti, and myself. Every morning is trouble to send him to school. Now like it getting worse. Trouble starting from evening now. The truth was, I was afraid to go to school. I was not afraid of school so much as I was afraid of Derek. Derek was the biggest, strongest boy in the whole school, and normally I would avoid him or exchange a few blows with him, knowing that when I got home, there would be more. My mother did not approve of fighting, and no matter how I tried to explain, her retort would always be, go cut a whip. But tomorrow would be different. The school was having a competition with three other schools in the district, and Derek and myself were chosen to sing for the school. Let's continue another excerpt from the short story. I knew my mother would not understand about Derek. She would say that I should be proud and that I should not let down the school. She knew that there was a competition, but I did not tell her that I was in it. I would only serve to worsen matters if I did. Yet another excerpt. The sound of a car honking behind me brought me back to reality. The tight feeling in my stomach returned, and I felt for sure that it was the police. I made a start to run when I heard a voice. Vishnu, want to lift to school? I spun around, and there sitting in her old Volkswagen was Miss Fernandez. I could not tell her I was planning to run away from school, yet to refuse a lift from a teacher was unthinkable. Reluctantly, I entered the car. The seat was hot, and I squirmed uncomfortably. Miss Hernandez smiled at me. Turn around, and in the back you will find a towel. Put it on the seat. I smiled gratefully and was soon sitting comfortably. So Vishnu, looking forward to the competition? Yes, miss, I lied. It was then it dawned on me. I was on the way to sing. I could not get out now. I closed my eyes and tried to see Derek grinning at me. Quickly I opened my eyes, and there, just ahead, was the school. A burst of laughter from the audience brought me back to reality. I looked around and saw the crowd below. I was sitting with the rest of the contestants awaiting my turn in the contest. So far, two contestants had performed. I knew that normally I could sing better than they could, but I wondered how it would be with Derek right behind me and the crowd facing me. Derek's turn was next. He went through the song without a flaw, except for one false note at the beginning. But after that, he went smoothly. At the end, the school applauded loudly, and Derek walked back to his seat. The stage looked like a million miles away, and I felt my knees buckling. As I approached the microphone, I fixed my gaze on the corner door and started. After the first few notes, I felt myself going along easily, and before I knew it, I was finished. There was a split second pause, and then I heard the applause. I could not hear whether it was good or bad. All I felt was relief. I walked back quietly, and as I sat down, I felt a tap on my shoulder. I looked up, and there was Derek. He whispered, "I think you stand a good chance of winning. The boy who was fourth was not as good as you were." I looked at him and noticed for the first time that he was smiling, not grinning. Somehow, I whispered back, "Thanks," and smiled back. He sneaked back to his chair, and as I looked at him jauntily walking back to his seat, I realized that maybe he had never grinned at all. That's the end of the Irma's story. Thank you. May you all have a great evening. Bye now.